Hey, let's check in with Mia and see how her business is going. In our last video, you advised Mia on how to make big profits from her lemonade stand. Did it work? Well, Mia sold her first batch of 50 cups of lemonade at $1 per cup. How much revenue did Mia get? $50, right? Awesome! And let's say that between lemons, sugar, water, cups, and ice, it costs Mia 50 cents to make each cup of lemonade. It costs $25 to make a batch of lemonade that yields 50 servings. Using our profit formula, Mia would profit $25 on that batch. Way to go, Mia! Now, $25 is great, but $100 would be better. In fact, what's to stop Mia from just making lemonade 24/7 and raking in the endless profits? How should Mia figure out how much to make and when to stop? Well, in today's lesson, we're going to find out. We will be discussing marginal analysis. By the end of this lesson, you should be able to answer the following questions. What is marginal cost? What is marginal revenue? How do you conduct a marginal analysis? How can you use marginal analysis to maximize profit? And you should start thinking about the big picture question. What are some ways you can use marginal analysis in your daily life? Here's our overall question. Once Mia sells out that first batch, should she make more lemonade? At first, it seems obvious, right? Mia earned $25 for the first batch, so she'll earn more profit for the next batch, right? And the next? But wait. Economists tell us that Mia needs more information before she can make her decision. She needs to know the marginal revenue and marginal cost of more lemonade. How are marginal revenue and cost different from overall revenue and cost? Well, marginal revenue is the extra revenue you'd get from selling one more unit of a product. So, after Mia has sold 50 cups, how much more revenue could she make by selling the 51st cup? Marginal cost is the extra expense a company incurs when it increases its production by one unit. In Mia's case, that would be the cost of making that 51st cup. This seems clear enough, but why should the first cup be any different than the 51st? Well, you might be surprised. There are many reasons why the marginal revenue or cost might change. Let's look at a few. Marginal revenues can be affected by many things. For example, new competitors can make it harder to sell more products. Prices that are set too high can reduce the number of customers willing to buy more products. Trends and fashions can affect the demand for a product. Marginal cost is highly changeable too. For example, the price of factors of production might change. Bulk production might lower costs. For example, it can cost a lot more per shirt to make 10 custom t-shirts than it would cost to make 10,000 of the same shirt. New safety rules or regulations can make it more expensive to produce. External factors can also affect marginal cost and marginal revenue. For example, natural disasters, global recessions, and pandemics can all have an effect. Make a prediction now. What are some ways that Mia's marginal cost and revenue might change? Pause the video and record your thoughts in the PDF. Thank you. How can we use this info to help Mia decide whether or not to make more lemonade? She needs to conduct a marginal analysis. That's the process of calculating the marginal profit. The marginal profit is the amount of profit generated by producing and selling one additional unit of a product or service. The formula for that is marginal revenue minus marginal cost. After Mia has sold 50 cups, how much profit could she make by selling the 51st cup? It's a tricky question. The revenue she'll make selling that 51st cup is $1. The real question is that profitable? What if Mia sold those first 50 cups of lemonade and there was still a huge line of thirsty customers waiting? Should she make more? Let's do the marginal analysis. The marginal cost of making the 51st cup of lemonade is still 50 cents. And with all those customers waiting, Mia knows she can still sell it for $1, giving her a marginal revenue of $1. What's the marginal profit? If you said 50 cents, you're right. $1 minus 50 cents leaves Mia with a marginal profit of 50 cents. Is it worth it to make more lemonade? You betcha. But what if there was not a customer in sight and the sky was turning dark? Mia might not be able to sell another cup. Even though the marginal cost to make the cup of lemonade is still 50 cents, the marginal revenue could be zero if Mia can't sell it at all. What would the marginal profit be if it doesn't sell? Let's see, $0 minus 50 cents equals minus 50 cents? Yikes! In that case, making more lemonade wouldn't increase her profits. It would reduce them. So, how should Mia decide when to produce more or stop? That's right, she should use this kind of marginal analysis. She should keep making more as long as the marginal profit is positive. Once it's not, she'll stop. Now, let's put our knowledge into practice. Consider our example. How could Mia use the ideas in this section to maximize her profit? Pause the video and record your thoughts in the PDF. So, you can think of marginal analysis like a profit-boosting guide. It's like a cost-benefit analysis for selling more. By using marginal analysis, businesses can find that sweet spot where the marginal revenue meets or exceeds the marginal cost. So they can produce and sell up to that point to maximize their profits. Marginal analysis helps businesses set the right prices. If the price gets too high, fewer people will buy and marginal revenue will decrease. For example, if Mia got so excited about the line of thirsty customers, she might increase the price. If people really want her lemonade, maybe they'd be willing to pay more. But that strategy could backfire. She could end up with a bunch of angry people walking away and no sales. Marginal analysis also helps businesses allocate their resources wisely. If one product has a greater marginal profit than another, it might be worth moving more resources into making that. Also, marginal analysis helps businesses make expansion decisions. Would the additional investment cost be worth the added revenue? Or would it be a waste of resources? What are some additional ways that Mia might be able to use marginal analysis to help her business? Pause the video and record your thoughts in the PDF. Let's recap what we've learned. Marginal analysis is like a secret weapon for making smarter business choices and driving success. It involves identifying the marginal revenue and marginal cost and calculating the marginal profit. Marginal revenue is the extra revenue you get from selling one more unit of a product. Marginal cost is the extra expense a company incurs when it increases its production by one unit. Both marginal cost and marginal revenue can vary based on a business's decisions, as well as external factors. That's why it's important for businesses like Mia's to continuously conduct marginal analysis in order to maximize their profits. In the next lesson, we'll take a look at specialization, another strategy that producers can use to help maximize profit. Until then, keep investing in your future one lesson at a time. See you next time. Hey, hey.